Welcome to the stream. Day 80 something. Making Songbringer a Zelda like game for Windows, Mac, Linux. And this boss is finally behaving how he should. And quite difficult to beat, actually, with only 3 hearts, 3 oranges. Which I think I'm going to change to teeth. Secret is, his vulnerable spot is when he attacks. Oh, I got him. Nice. Okay, so here's... Before, I was working on his death animations, and I was like, what's the best way to do these 2D animations for bosses? Because it's going to be a lot of work. There's so many pixels in the boss animations that, you know, it's just a lot more work doing the pixel art. And to do a bunch of frames for this guy with his huge hammer and everything falling on the ground is really difficult. And then if he were laying on the ground, it's also really difficult because I have to put a different collision box, either that or something, so the player can't really walk through him. So I'm thinking it's probably better anyways to have bosses turn into stone. So the second you beat them, they sit there and they stay like that. And they're just like encased in stone for the rest of the game. Until maybe in the last level you can do like a boss run and they all kind of like maybe come out of their stone and they're alive and you can fight them in the one level. So anyways, I'm going to do some animations here to turn them into pure stone and also put a collision box around him. So right now he's got a collision box. What's up, Ferk? Ferk17, hey, howdy. Welcome. Howdy do. So when enemies get hurt or they die, they remove their collision component. I'm going to make this so if it's a boss, it doesn't. And I'm going to go ahead and add actually a flag to their property list. Drop a boss. Now it has a flag called boss 1. There. So that puts that up there. Mars of Power, hello! Oh, dang. Sorry, man. Or, I didn't mean to call you man if you're not a man. If you're a woman. Hello! Marza, and welcome to the stream. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome, and welcome. Making this boss better. He's actually functioning a lot better than yesterday. I fixed all little bugs. All the things I thought were voodoo. So his weakness is once he does that strike, he stays there for a second. But it's still not that much of a weakness, so he's actually pretty difficult to beat. Nah. So I'm going to make him turn into stone, actually. And the first step to that is when a boss dies, it doesn't remove its collision component. So get int so if it has the boss flag if it doesn't have the boss flag it removes its collision component. If it does have the boss flag, it's not going to remove the collision component. I'm going to test that out on some of these enemies here. Cool. So I can walk on that guy's corpse. There's no more collision component. This one too. Yeah. Okay. And then I'm going to go and beat this guy. We should not have... tough. So if I beat this guy, he should now have a collision component. If I can beat this guy. Oh, man. Okay, so I'm going to make him a little less difficult to fight right now. Hello. What's up, Chaos Gaming? Is there Co Xperia? XP? Is there Co XP? I'm not sure what you mean by Co XP. Yeah, please clarify. Oh, thank you. Thanks, Ferk. Thanks a lot. Yeah, I'm glad you think it looks awesome and that I'm sharing. That's really cool. I appreciate that. I'm glad that sharing is helpful to other people and it's of value. And personally, I think it's kind of cool because I can look back over the course, or anyone can look back over the course of making this entire game. So I think that'll be pretty cool. You know, if this turns into a popular game and people like it, people can go back and be like, whoa, look at this. I can look at all the videos of how it was made. What was I just thinking? Oh, I'm going to make his hit points a lot less for a minute. XP? You just mean like that there's experience points in the game? And if that's what you mean, no, there's no experience points in this game. Because it's kind of like... It's meant to be more like Zelda in the sense that accomplishment comes from progress in the game, not necessarily how many things you kill. Okay, there. So he's going to die like this. Oh! I can still walk on him, so that means that it did remove his collision component still. Huh. Nice. So, what's wrong with this? If E profile get int boss. Okay, let's just set a breakpoint there. Galloping cow! Oh, that's a really good point. Really, really good point, actually. I guess he could block doors. I didn't think about that. I thought about him blocking the item chest, so I made the item chest. Oh, you know what I could do about doors in that case? I can actually set it so there's a little gap in the wall where only you can fit through and he can't go to. So, oh, but then he could just block the gap. Oh, no, I can actually add a single tile outside of the gap. So, yeah, there's ways of doing it so I can actually make it so the level is set up so that he can never actually block something off. Because he's so big that he can't get through certain tiles, so there's ways to do that. And yes, that is a very good point. Hello, Alex Pita. Welcome. Happy Sunday, if it's Sunday for you. Are there places in the world right now that are already Monday? Yes, there are. Like Australia. Pushable. Oh, no, that's a good point. Maybe you could just be pushable. Huh. Okay, so I've grabbed this boss string. It is one. So it's going to return one. All right. Oh, it's just stupid logic there. So if git profile boss is zero, then we remove the compilation component. Yeah, totally. Totally. That can be done. That's a good thought. So first, let's make sure these guys can still have no collision. Okay, no collision box there. What the heck? Okay, let's like log out. Okay, check out this debug output. Is boss one? Exactly. Know what? Maybe something else is removing its collision component. So I'm gonna verify what's going on by just checking the basics. First of all, I'm gonna completely remove the co remove collision box right there. Maybe there's somewhere else in the code that I did remove the collision component. Yeah, okay, that was the problem. It's removing the collision box somewhere else. So check out everywhere in the code that I'm calling remove component. Of course, there's the method. Okay, it's only in system. Here's one of them. This is for the wall, though. It's removing secrets. It might be here. But no, this is. I'm pretty sure this is not going to be hit. The other possibility is that maybe I'm setting the category for the collision. Yeah, it must be the category. Okay, let's go back to these. I realize what it is. Okay, so the way collision boxes work right now in my code is that The player can always step on a foe, and that's what allows the player to get hurt. So the player stepping onto a foe causes a collision with their collision components and causes the player to get damaged and knocked back. So in order to make this guy turn into like a pillar of stone, he's going to need to turn into a just change his collision component. So e.collision.category equals k filter static. So instead of removing the collision component, we're changing him to be static if he's a boss. And in fact, I think this will be a little clearer if I do it like this. I'm checking for one there. Okay, that should work. And then we'll do a cool animation where he turns into stone. Oh, what? Still, Okay, let me check that. Okay, so it's hitting that collision category. Oh, it's removing the position component as well. Ah, okay, so that's huge as well. So of course it needs a collision component and the position component for collisions. Okay. That should work. I always say that and then it doesn't work. Alright, yeah, okay. That's all it needed. And it looks like he's small enough in his collision box that he's not going to be able to block at least the south door there. We get him to die over here by this other door, and I think he would actually still be small enough that he's not going to be blocking doors. So he's about two tiles tall, and the doors are three tiles. So yeah, he's never gonna be able to block a door completely. So that's good. For now, I'm not gonna worry about that. What's up, Black Iron? Okay, so now I'm gonna make him so he turns into stone. So I'm gonna get an animation going for him. Okay, so this is going to be a super easy one, which I love. I love easy animations. Let me save this as death. Oh, the player's collision box isn't a whole tile tall, so it's really not too much of an issue. Oh, I get you what you mean, though. If he's in the very exact center... how tall is the player? Let me see. He's only six tall, which is... A tile is 10. She's a little over half. So I'm going to make sure the boss is not tall enough to block too many tiles. So it's currently 38 tall. If he's 35, That'll make him so he is exactly. A tile is 20 by 12, so a tile is 12. So if the door is. The doorway is 36. Oh, he's going to need to be like 24. Yeah, the doorway is 36. And we need 12. We need 12 free pixels to be able to have twice the distance of the player's height. That's 24. Yeah, so he can be a maximum of 24 pixels tall. Or 24. We'll just leave it for like that for now. What's up, dude? Thank you. You're welcome. I mean, I'm glad glad you're saying thanks for those. I hope that that makes a good difference for you. So this taunt animation is very similar to this death. Overwrite the existing death. And so he just goes 1, 2. He's going to be stuck in this. And then these are going to be a bunch more frames while he's turning gray. I'll leave those. Okay, so we're on frame 2. And do some frames where he's turning gray. Guess I'll do a hue saturation layer. With editing the mask. So I'm grabbing the selection for this guy, and I'm going to paint the areas black that I know I don't want. And this combined with the cool sound effect is going to be, I think, pretty good for. It's pretty good for that frame. What happened to this? Oh. Okay, a little less on his hammer. Yeah, that's a good frame 1. Okay, so I'm going to merge these so I don't have to worry about this hue saturation layer anymore. And this is going to be frame 3. And now duplicating frame 2. Do another one of these little dillies. Okay, so now he's gonna go a little farther. All right. Yes, there is going to be portals. Good question. I think portals A are going to be super awesome to animate. Can't wait to do that. And B, they're actually going to be little teleportation things. So you're gonna get a teleport cube. It's one of your items. So you can throw a cube down at any point in the world, and it's like the place you're going to warp back to. So you can set any point to be your warp back point, and you can use your other cube to warp to it. But I'm open to ideas. If anybody has any better ideas, I'd love to hear them. 'Cause maybe that's not the coolest thing or in the world to just have it work that way. Okay. We're on frame five now. Painting a little more white. Yes, I'm making the boss turn to stone. That way it's kind of like a, I don't know, you feel a sense of accomplishment too. Because you can go back into the levels you've already beaten, right? So rather than just having the boss room be empty, I think it'd be way cooler to actually have the boss sitting there in stone. And also, it's easier to animate and easier to deal with the collision boxes and things like that rather than the way that he was dying. Okay, so wait, this last one I'm not quite happy with. I want to make him so. His actual face turns all gray in this frame. Cool. Now duplicate this one, save a little progress so far. Merge these. That's interesting. Huh. Because right now there's a chest in the room. But yeah, it would be nice to have the chest be obvious. Because you definitely want to get the item that he gets. But then having another secondary item for when you could actually break the statue, that's an interesting thought. Or maybe you get a more powerful sword during the game. So like you're gonna get like sword level 2 and 3. So maybe sword level 2 is the only thing that can break bosses. I'm gonna think about that. Because I don't know, I kind of think it'd be cool to have a boss run level, which was mentioned yesterday in yesterday's stream, and I like that idea a lot. So I don't know if that would explain it very well. If the bosses turn to stone and they break, is that gonna. All right, let's do one last frame after this. Oh, it's just all gray. Okay. Delete layer mask. Bang. Merge. Cool. What's really going to make this effect cool is the sound effect. That'll really help it go turn into be awesome. Let's see that all at 0.2. Yeah, 0.2 is a little too long. .15 is pretty good. Okay, so I'm going to export all these. We got the fuzz folder, frame rate 10, straight unmatted. All that's looking good. And then I'm gonna, I should verify it, put out the right frames. Still getting to use the render to video feature. Getting used to it. Good, we got dev 0 through 7. So we got 8 frames. And that's, yeah, how many I exported. Cool. Got 8 frames. Now I'm gonna hook it up to the property list for his release. Okay, so we need to do one thing to make sure the bosses, when they're recreated after they've already died, they need to have a collision component. So they always have a position. We need to have a collision. So slow that down a little bit. and do a sound effect. So 0.15 times 8 frames. That'll be how many seconds long this animation is. Oh, that's one thing. If he's dead, yeah, yeah, that's a really good idea. I like that. Yeah, crafting for sure is going to be fun to add to the game. And I like that idea of crafting sword upgrades. Okay, oh yeah. So, this guy when... No. When it creates the collision box for the player, for the enemy. If the player is, or if the enemy's not alive, then the collision category is K-filter. Yeah, we'll do it this way. Collision category, K-filter static. So, doesn't hurt the player to step on stone. Pillars of stone. Oh, yep. So there's an issue with him being a little too wide. So width is going to be 60. The player's width is 10. So his max can be 40 or 39. Let me just check those numbers. Area, create transients. Oh, the player's 12. Okay, so 12 on each side, 60 tiles wide. Okay, so hard to do it. My art pen is crazy to do regular programming with. 60 minus 24, 36, so 35. And the other one was 36 minus 12. Let's do this 23 high. So there, that's the maximum size that he could be and die without blocking an exit. And let's see if he still kind of feels right as far as his... Sweet. So, all right, now I just need to turning into stone sound effect. So I'm going to put this art pen away for a second. Make a sound effect. get a little inspiration by just searching for some words. Sometimes I like to do that. Stoner. Ha. Subconscious. Stone. That's pretty good. It's really crackly. Gosh, that's really lucky to get that on the first try. This is a nice one too. It's under the Zero license. This is a big sound. 11 megs though. Well worth it. That's gonna be fun. Okay, and then, so add a cool sound effect, so he just crackles into that stone. And then I'm going to do a couple more effects. One is his taunt to be a little bit better. So I'm going to add another frame to his taunt. So he's lifting it. This is where... he starts off at... not there. Yeah, probably two frames, and one in between each one of these. Oh. Just notice his arm is all off in this one. All right, so frame. Gosh, these get so messed up because of this stupid propagate frame one thing. Should not be the default. Okay, let's get this sound effect going. I always like to save all my sounds I get from Freesound in this one folder, the ones that I know I'm gonna use. And that way I can go back and easily reference the sound ID and the player's or the person's username so I can credit them when the game is released. So it sounds pretty good right about there. I need 0.15 times 8. 1.2 seconds ish. I'm just gonna grab a bunch, copy to new. I'm looking at my little duration there in the bottom right. About 1.2, maybe a little more. I can just. I want it to have a little more tail though, so I'm going to add a little more than just 1.2. Integrity at its finest. So crop that out, make it mono. Mono sounds are awesome. They take up less room. They can be panned and the benefits of mono. You don't get any kind of stereo imaging issues. Sometimes if you have exactly the same wave in the left channel as you do in the right channel and they're off by exactly one phase of their wave, they will effectively cancel each other out. Even though you'll have audio, you have tons of audio, to the human ear, they will be effectively canceled out. So mono solves that issue. That's a pretty sweet sound. I like that. So I'm gonna save this. Put it in raw. This is Boston. All right, and I can hook this up to the boss now for his sound. So sound for release, we didn't have one, but he does now. I like that, but there were so many things going on there at that last bit that you couldn't really tell that it was about to play the boss, that actual boss sound. So I'm gonna delay that whole process somehow. So I could either make the I think it's probably best to actually delay it on in the system. So we've got collision category foe right here. Create an is boss flag. And then Yeah, really, I mean, everything else can be done, so I just need to do delay playing the sound. So go e.render.runAction. No, schedule render.sprite.schedule once. Schedule callback with a delay. This callback takes a float. Write a little lambda function. Float's gonna be unused, so I'm not even gonna name it. Delay is dependent on if it's a boss. So is boss, say point, say a whole half second. Otherwise it just happens instantly. And this is a death nm delay. The key is important. Oh, and this is gonna take the entity. It's gonna delay the sound and the animation by a half second. So let's try that out. Is boss, why isn't this? Why don't you like that? Is boss bool? I'm gonna try a whole another a second at least there. Yeah, that was a little better. Cool. I guess there's one issue, and that's that it's totally obstructing the view of this chest now. So yeah, I guess maybe you should be able to push them. Or strike them and they can move a little bit. Yeah, I know. Yep, if you were watching earlier, I took the boss's health down from 100 to 33 to test that out, his death. So, but yeah, thanks for mentioning that, because if I did space on that, it would be very important to change that back. So what else? Being able to push the boss actually would be pretty important. You know, in case there is any issues. That's gonna be a whole system, though. I think I'm gonna save that for later. This sound could be a little actually louder. Deeper. Yeah, you can barely hear that depth coming across like my laptop speakers there, but that is actually going to sound really cool on a good sound system. A little more bass. I want to do his taunt animation a little bit better here. So he's gonna have a couple more frames before he gets this all in the air. Okay, this is an easier. It's always crazy in Photoshop when you set up an animation in your timeline and then you go add more frames. Everything gets so messed up. So sometimes I just like delete all the frames from the timeline and then just go and redraw the animation. So this is his first pose. This is wonky here. Like, shoulders move up so many pixels. So, I guess it's okay. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna duplicate him. Yeah, duplicate this layer. What's up, monkey on a bus? Monkey on a bus! Why don't you make the boss crumble to a pile of rubble? That's interesting. So the reason I had him turn it into stone, because I like the fact that it's almost like a trophy as a player. Like, you can come, this is a Zelda game, so you can come back into this room at any point and you would see that, oh, I've already destroyed this boss. So it's kind of like a trophy. You're like, whoa, yes, I already got that guy. So if it was just a pile of rocks crumbling, that would solve some problems, but it probably wouldn't be as much of a feeling like, oh, I killed that guy already. So I don't know. It's a good suggestion. I will think about it. Maybe that's the best way to do it. Yeah, and was it Black Iron that mentioned that? Yeah, Black Iron already mentioned that. He was saying that you could destroy the statue and it would turn into something like maybe even an item. So really good thoughts. Thank you guys. I'm so excited to actually have some new thoughts on this to think about. Because yesterday, really, my plan was just to make him explode and turn into nothing. And that's just, A, it's not a trophy, and B, it's just kind of, you know, cheesy. That's right, it was Black Iron. Uh-huh. Cool. Okay, so this is going to be one frame between here and there. So it's going to be a little tiny bit lifted off the shoulder, but not much. Okay, so his head's going to be back on in the same place. Sort of like there-ish. A little bit more. Yeah, like about there. First, I'm going to do this. Commit that angle. Oh, maybe the skull stays intact. That's an idea. That combines the ideas, and now it is kind of like a trophy in the sense that his skull is there. That's cool. Definitely worth considering. No, don't be sorry. Please suggest things. Don't feel like you have to not suggest it if somebody else did already. And And yeah, and your suggestion is totally unique, Monkey on the Bus, so thank you. Yeah, I guess I wasn't really talking about that. I was talking more about it just being a trophy in the sense that it's something you can go back and visit, and like you see that you have actually already defeated that enemy. All right, Chaos Gaming, thanks for dropping by. Enjoy. Collect all nine. I like it. Okay, so halfway between this frame and that frame. Doop 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 doop. Cool. All right, so we got this is going to be the real zero. Is one. What's the difference between these? Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I love the ideas, guys. Thank you. What the heck is the difference? Oh, he just got his shoulders up. Okay, so now one frame between this one and that one. Oh, thanks, Mars of Power. Thank you. That's cool. You know what? I say it's almost like every stream, but I originally was just a programmer, and for 20 years or so, I believed, honestly, that I would never ever be able to make art, that it was just not my cup of tea, that, other people can do it, but I can't, and all that jazz. And then eventually one of my programmer friends, I watched him become an artist, and I was like, what? If he can do it, I can do it. That's kind of what spawned it. And then I bought an art pen, sat on my desk for a whole year. I never used it. It collected so much dust. I had to like blow dust off of it the first time I used it. But the one thing I was doing over that year was I was soaking up tons and tons of speed art. I was watching people do speed pixel art, speed paintings, just like taking other people's. Just watching other people make art. That's really all I did. And I didn't know it at the time, but I was learning a lot just by watching. And as soon as I finally picked up the pen again and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna give this another try. And it just basically unlocked so much creativity because now that I can make art and I'm confident making it, I have an infinite world now. I can create the entire aspect of all of games, sound-wise, music, pixel art, and also code now. So it's a very freeing thing. And I wrote a book about it. Not a book, but just a tiny little video series called From Programmer to Artist. So if there's anybody out there who is struggling with the same kind of things, it's on wizardfoo.com. This is my website. And it's called wizardfoo.com/book/from-programmer to artist. It's just a tiny little video series about that, about all the basics of art, including like shading, how to establish your own aesthetic, just the basics of making art. So, whoops. Sorry about that, everybody. I just turned off the chat window. We'll get that going again. Yeah, sure. There's really only one track made so far. And I can show you it by turning on the skip off the skip menu so you can see the intro where you pick up the sword. Sweet, thanks. So I've only written one song and it's a tiny one for when you pick up the sword, but I'll show you about what it sounds like. I'm probably gonna make this a little. This sounds kind of 8-bit, this song. And I'm probably gonna change up that style and make it a little less 8-bit and a little more modern electronic style. That's it. Sounds kind of crazy because you're not hearing any of the bass. You're just hearing it come over my laptop speakers. But it does sound cooler than that with the bass. I hear you, man. Why do you think that? What was it about it? Oh, it's exciting and thrilling. Oh, okay, I get you now. That's good, I guess. I hear you. Well, that's also not supposed to be a classic. You got a new item sound. It's supposed to be like this is the most epic thing you've ever gotten in the world. And I know it happens right at the very beginning of the game, but I really want to reward players that quickly in the game to be like, this is the dopest thing ever. That's why there's an entire track just written for that. Yeah, so I mean, I'm probably going to play with that and make it a little different anyway. So I will take your guys's feedback in mind when I do that. All right. That concludes that. Let's see how that's looking. Yeah, I use a pen. It's a bamboo Wacom tablet. It's like cheap. These are only $75 now. There's a better one though. Gosh, what was that one that somebody recommended the other day? I don't know. But it's also $75. It's like better than the bamboo for sure. But this was the cheapest pen I could find when I was learning to make art. And like I said, it sat on my desk for a whole year before I used it. Steering wheel. I'd love to see that. I'd love to see somebody make some art with the steering wheel. Cool, yeah. I recommend if you have any interest in actually making art, to just dive in. Okay, so this is one frame where it's really messed up because he goes and stands up really tall, and then he stands back down. So two and one. So one-ish, I think, is the one I should be using there. So it goes zero, one. Okay, his head's two. Heads gets crazy there. Oh, that's kind of cool, actually, now that his shoulders shrug in that frame. Okay. So one thing, though, his head. I don't like his head in this frame. So I'm going to move it back. One thing that really, really helped me with Photoshop too was establishing some good shortcuts. So I have my mind set up so it's like originally all the shortcuts in Photoshop are kind of dumb because they're all these letters that are strewn out all over the keyboard. And so if you go in and you just customize your shortcuts, you can actually set them up so they're all accessible with one hand. Yeah, Monkey on a Bus, actually, that's the way I designed it to play, actually, at first. So you couldn't move until the boss finished his taunt. And I designed a mechanic for that yesterday, and it created a whole bunch of voodoo and stuff because I forgot that the second I pause input for the player, it pauses a lot more systems too. So I need to, you know what? I just figured out the answer to do that. There should be two different pauses. There should be pausing the player's input only, and there should be pausing all of the other systems. So in things like where it transitions from one screen to the next, it pauses everything. And then there's also the just pausing the player's input, which is another way to do it. So yeah, I will do that. I'll finish that up and redo that system so that there's two types of pauses and the player or the enemies can use the taunt. So yesterday I had that in the boss. It would go like this. It would go input lock when it's doing his taunt. And then when he chooses a target, it went input unlock. But both those kind of got messed up, so because of that whole pause issue. So yeah, that's a really good point. And we're both on the same page there because that's originally how it was designed. But I do also want to make him hard enough where getting some free hits in is actually kind of a help. Sweet. The only thing, I don't want him to do that when he's lowering it back down. So I'm going to do one more frame. What's with this? Don't propagate one. Never propagate frame one. So annoying. Okay, so this is going to be two-ish. That's true. Good point, Mars Power. I'm glad you're on the same page as me with the speed runs. I'm so excited about speed runs. That's why you can enter a world code that you know, and you'll just be able to run through those kind of worlds. I think speed runs are really cool, and that's also why I added the timer to the game. So you've got what's up with that? So it tracks how long you've actually played each time. Whoa. I introduced a new bug there. So yeah, there's a timer there in the bottom right that actually tracks your whole time. So it's kind of official for speedrunners. Cool. Okay, so clean this guy up. Sweet. Yeah, I love seeing like old school Zelda speedruns. all of them. Secret of Mana, speedruns. All the speedruns are super cool. And they're great for festivals and events, things like that. But cool. I like the way he lifts it, but there's this one little bit where he puts it back down. Needs to rotate completely in this one. So rotate this hammer a lot. So I was talking about shortcuts there a second ago, and the ones I use the most are S, which brings up to my pencil tool. D is the eraser, so that's kind of in the middle of the keyboard there. Q is the selection tool. W is the rectangular selection tool. E is the lasso. And then at the bottom of the keyboard, I've got Z, X, and C. So Z and X increase and decrease the size of my cursor. So I can easily change the size that I'm actually drawing at, and same with the eraser. And then, yeah, so, and then C is the eyedropper tool. So there, like most of the things I use for pixel art are all within reach of the left side of the keyboard there. So I don't have to change my hand position very much when I'm doing the most of the common tasks of pixel art. So that saves some time. It's true, right, Bullseye Boy? Yep, undo is also really important. And that's also another thing you can customize in on Photoshop. And by default, the Control Z doesn't really work to undo. So weird. But you can set it up so it does work as an undo. Dang. Alex Pita, this is sort of a serious slash not so serious Zelda. So it's sort of like, I don't know, almost like Sword and Sorcery aesthetic with a Zelda-like game. Yeah, right, exactly. So I that's what I'm saying. I changed that by default to be Control Z is an actual undo instead of step back once or something, whatever it is. Yeah, Ziri, for sure. I believe that you should only learn, well, for me at least, I feel like I've wasted so many years learning software. You know what I mean? If I were to condense my entire game development career into actually trying to relearn everything in less time, I would stick to one tool only and never ever switch. And you know what I mean? Like when you could spend a whole year or two just learning Photoshop, or you could spend a year or two learning GIMP. You know, you spend a year learning Paint. You could spend a year learning Ableton, Logic, like all the different music softwares. So I think, honestly, I would find one piece of software that I thought was excellent and stick with it. Even though I don't think Photoshop is perfectly excellent, there's so many issues with it as well. But I've learned it enough, and it does enough of what I need it to do, that I'm never going to switch at this point. So I hope that makes sense. So it's all about time, saving time. Oh, yeah, yeah, I heard you. I get you. And it's okay to post links here, of course. Oh, what's up, Zeith? Cool, let me check it out. Hold on a sec. I gotta finish this selection before I lose it. Context-aware dialogue systems. And welcome to the stream, Zeith. Well, that's pulling up. Ah, interesting. Yeah, I like that a lot because that's definitely one of the next things I'm going to work on is the narrative. How to make writers even more awesome. I'm surprised this isn't written by Eric. The writer guy, Eric from Old Man Murray. Oh, this is from 2012. Cool. Cool, I gotta check this out. This looks awesome. This is a PDF. I'm gonna save it, I think. Save to desktop. Ah, cool. Awesome. Thank you again for the awesome link. Zeith was the one that mentioned MetaZelda, and that changed everything. Gosh, I'm really glad that I found that article. It saved me a lot of time. Or Zeith mentioned that article because it saved so much time. Because I was thinking about doing the maze generation algorithm and reworking that and how I would add keys and things like that. But it was just really nice to have it all laid out. You know, Tom Coxon, the maker of Lena's Inception, has already published a bunch of articles on how to procedurally generate dungeons with lock and key puzzles. And I took that article and kind of made my own system. But it really, really helped. Okay, so is that working now? 2, 3. What we got? This last frame, when it goes from here, from there to there, is a little bit weird. Okay, so if you have sit a little higher in the air, I think it'll be more natural and explain why his hand has only moved so much. Kind of geeking out on this frame here, but you know, it's all worth it. Art takes a lot of time, at least for me, being kind of a beginner, but I agree. I think it's worth it. You know, when you see good art in a game, you're like, wow, awesome. All right. Yeah. Yeah, it is. Exactly. This is a taunt animation, and that was an accident actually. There a few frames ago when He had his that laugh movement or that bobbing movement. I don't know if there'll be a ha 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 on the screen, but there is already a taunt noise. So I'm going to export this and see if it works with the current noise. Okay, so that's enough messing around with it for now. It's not quite as smooth as I'd like it to be when he's putting it back on his shoulder, but you know what? I can't just mess with it all day, so I'm going to delete these middle frames. Not delete them, but just remove them from the animation here. So it's going to go 3, 4. Oh, actually, it does need those. Now that it's a longer animation. Sand Raider in Star Wars. Yes, yeah, I know what you mean. Okay, so it used to be 2.5 seconds long, and now it is 12 frames times 0.2. Yeah, we can make this out to be right. Oh gosh, that's exactly right. Cool. Yeah, it's pretty. What sound do they make? Sand Raiders. Ooh dee dee. Cool. Okay, so let's export all these. I got to set them to 0.1 so they export correctly. And then save this. Export render to video. We're still in the right folder. We got the right name. All these other settings look good. Check the sequence. Yeah, we got taunt 0 through 11. Cool. Wizard, please. What do you mean, please? Please, please make it oh, please stop trying to make their sounds with my mouth. So we got 12 frames. Each one is going to be 0.2 long. Let's see how that looks. Oh, we still got this. I got to skip. Skip the menu. Menu skipping saves a lot of time. I'm gonna make sure we're at the right place too. Yeah, 3, 4, 1. All right. Cool. So what else today? I like the way he's dying now. I love that he's turning to stone. Yeah, cool. That was awesome. I want to make it a little tiny bit longer per frame so he takes a second. To put it back on his shoulder. So I'm going to try 0.25. What's that going to be? 0.25. Oh, that's going to be 3.0 total, right? 0.25. Oh, I try and use my art pad as a mouse cursor sometimes, but it's crazy. So no, I don't want 0.3. I want it to be more like 2.6. So 0.2221. Okay. Yeah, that worked out just perfect. Oh, I know what this room needs is some more health. So I'm going to put some little... Sweet. And, you know, there's still a few bugs with the actual roof system. The roof, as you can tell, his hammer is being occluded by the roof there. That needs to be fixed. Yeah, I like how he's turning to stone. It's really cool. Yeah, the growl is pretty cool. That's also from Freesound. Just cleaned up the sound just a little bit. That's all. Let's try... Okay, yeah. I'm going to add a health chest to this room. A couple health chests, I think. So probably a health chest... One like over here. I don't have any health chests in the game, actual code for that, so that might take a minute to actually write this, but maybe a health chest up here in the upper left and another health chest over here. So I'm thinking some kind of like thing that you just hit once and it'll emit some health. Because when he's, I'm going to put my art pen away. When he's at full health, he's a lot harder to fight. Yeah, it totally is. Yeah, you're right. That's probably what it is. So I actually made sure of that last night. I made sure and I boosted the bass on it and listened to my headphones. My headphones got a good bass. So, yeah, let's fight him at full health. He's normally at 100, which is really challenging, especially for the first boss. I don't know. Actually, the bosses will be arranged randomly, I think. But at 100 health, you got to really have a good strategy to beat him. Kind of got to like anticipate when he's going to shoot that hammer down. Good. Boom. That's the first time I've ever fought him and only lost half a health. Cool. Look how much blood there is on the ground, too. Cool. Yeah, I'm liking this guy. He's really fun to fight, actually. Sweet, Black Iron. Thanks, man. It's OS X, Windows, Linux, iOS, Android. And if the Kickstarter goes well, it'll also be like Wii U, PlayStation Vita. So like Wii U and PlayStation Vita are going to be some kind of stretch goals on there. But yeah, this is Coco2DX. So I get to write this in one code base of C++ and release it for several different engines. Though it'll be a lot of testing and beta testing work to get it to work on all those platforms. But at least I don't have to change much of the code. Okay, so let's do some... I'm going to think about how to add some chests to that room, because, like, for most players, I think it's going to be very difficult to beat him without at least maybe, you know, two recharges of health there, or two heart or two oranges worth of health. So I would do a container. I guess I could just do regular item chests as they are now. Dying, you're talking about dying animation for the player or dying animation for the enemy? Yeah, exactly, Mars of Power. So the way it'll work on iOS and Android is that you'll actually have virtual, you'll have a virtual D-pad and a virtual A and B buttons. And it'll also work for game controllers. So if you have a game controller for your iPad or iPhone or whatever, you can use a game controller. I'm not sure how those are actually... I wonder how many good ones there are these days, because I know there's a few of them here. Dang, that one's expensive. This is from the Apple Store. Of course it's expensive. Moga Rebel, also $80. Dang. What's this cheapo one? Look at that. It just looks light. Yeah, this is iPad. Works with an iPad though. Bluetooth. So I think this would be a cool way to play the game, because the way I prefer to play it right now is with the gamepad, and it already works. I like to play with these Buffalo ones. They're Super Nintendo style. And actually, I'm going to plug it in and fight the boss one more time with the gamepad, because I haven't tried that in a minute. Ooh, I got a cord knot over here. What's the health bar? The courage. Interesting. Well, of course it has to be, yeah. That's why it'll have a virtual D-pad, but I'm thinking it's going to be more fun to play with gamepad. I just have never really liked virtual D-pads that much. Oh, yeah. You have so much more control with the gamepad. Especially over the up, down, left, right. Gotcha! Getting better at fighting this guy. Yeah, definitely more enjoyable with a gamepad. So that's really cool. So yeah, let's add a little item chest. So there's a bit of code here in area which actually creates items. Shield console. Why haven't I heard of that? I've heard of the Ubuntu one. Did this just come out recently? It's portable? Preview 2015. Yeah, it sounds like it's new, huh?
The gaming frontier. Billions of bits and bytes circling the earth.
Okay, I don't need to hear the whole ad. I'll check that out later, though. Oh, it has been out for a while. Okay. Well, Coco's compiled for the PS Vita. I'm not exactly sure how that works. I think they're OpenGL. I gotta look into it. Because so it might require some tweaks to their engine to get it to compile and everything. I'm not exactly sure what's supported, like, or what language Vita is using and everything, and whether they're using OpenGL or not. So maybe I can't actually support PS Vita. I don't know. Or maybe it'll require some tweaking to actually get it to work. Oh, okay. Interesting. So is this like a popular platform, the Shield? I haven't seen any Kickstarter projects lately even mentioning it. But you know, maybe all I've seen is Wii U and PlayStation Vita, and I think that's it. Okay. Interesting. So it's a cool platform, but it's not popular yet. I like Ouya. Ouyas are, I think you pronounce it Ouya, right? The O-U-Y-A. That platform is cool because, I mean, once you support Android, you're already supporting Ouya. Nice. Cool. Since you guys mentioned that, we'll check out this Shield platform. See how much effort it would require to get it to get the game to work on it. All right, so I'm over my time here for my videos, but I think I'll go 5 more minutes and see if I can get an item chest in the room with the player. So it's really going to boil down to just adding a few different components. So I'm just gonna hack it in there really quick. I'm gonna add in 2 chests with some health in them. Darkjeer, welcome to the stream, Darkjeer. How long do you need to learn this? That's a really broad question there. I'm not exactly sure what you're asking. How long I learned to learn a program? How long it takes to learn to make art? How long it learns to take make music? So please be more specific. Interesting. Oh, wow. Huh. Okay, so if flags and K flag boss, I'm going to create a couple more entities here. We need the profile, render, position, not hidden, or has. We want to do just, yeah, we need that one. Need this one. Okay, so we got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're going to need to do, let's go entities, pushback. Entity create. These are some handy dandy methods I just created recently to create multiple entities at once. So I can do basically all this. New profile. Profile component. How long does it take to learn to program a game? Well, you know, it all depends. It really depends on how much programming experience you already have. Man, I don't know. I think you could get to the point where you're making a game like this in a year or two if you really, 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 really focus. So, I mean, it totally depends on you and how dedicated you are. And, you know, there's a lot to it. I don't know. Maybe there's some other people on here on the stream that can comment on that. And if anybody else is out there is learning to make games and how long it's taken them. So I'm going to add one more method that can create six entities or six components. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, it's 7. Oh, well, we'll just add another component. Entity, add component. Entities.back. This is going to be a pillar with, oh, we don't want the area item. We want K item life inside this. K filter container. That's okay. Oh, cool, man. Well, good. Well, if you already know C++, I mean, maybe it would be faster for you. You know, it all depends on what language you want to be using. If you really want to be using C++ to make games, then your next steps are to find an engine that you really, really dig. So, like, you know, C++, your options are, like, Unreal Engine. You got Cocos 2DX. There's also, like, SFML, or what? Not SFML, but GLFW. There's a few different C++ engines out there. So, if I were you and you really want to make games and you really want to make them with C++, go find an engine you really, really like that works with C++. And thanks, man. Okay, so going to creating this in the right position to position component, position, render, collision, loop profile, position. This is going to be tile pause. I need a function for this. I've been doing this so many times. So it's going to be get tile pause and returns a vec2. It basically just does that. So get tile pause. Git topos xy return vec2. So width times a half. No, this is going to be x. I thought this was x plus a half. And then y. Y times south size at height. Whoa, you're up late. No worries, man. You're welcome. Whoa. Y'all are definitely up late. Just as late as I am every night. Once it becomes 3 a.m., I'm like, oh, I'm up a little too late tonight. I feel bad. I feel bad for staying up so late all the time. So I think the get tile pause is correct. Yeah, x plus a half. There we go. Yeah, it's Xcode has really gotten worse over the past few updates. They just have gotten worse and worse with their autocomplete and their jump to. So jump to sometimes works, sometimes doesn't, but it used to work really well. Black Iron 826, where are you? Australia? It's only midnight in the UK. Wow, everybody's from different countries. This is cool. So here's where we're going to do this get tile pause. Actually, that should be a static method. Oh, can't be const if it. You know what? No, it shouldn't be static because in some cases, eventually, this engine might work in that it does different tile positions for different levels. So X is going to be like 1 or 2. Y is going to be like 5-ish to put it on the left side of the screen. Oh, 8 p.m. Oh, you on the East Coast? Yeah, you got to be the East Coast. That's what I'm saying. Jump to is the worst. Yeah. And it used to work perfect. Apple just dropped the ball on it. Okay, so let's see if there's an item chest there now. On the left side of the screen. Alright, cool. We got an item. Oh, but it's going to be locked. Wait, no. It's not locked. Because it doesn't have the other code. Sweet. Alright, we've got an item chest. And if I put it one more to the left, and it doesn't necessarily need a shadow component sitting there in the corner, I'm going to put another one there on the right side of the screen. So this is going to be tile pause for width minus one. So there, now there's two health. Yep, I'm in the US, on the West Coast. I'm in Oakland, California. So yeah, and I might put these up in the top part of the level too. Okay, what's up with that? Width minus two. Nice. Okay, we've got item chests in here now. I want them to look different, of course, so I'm going to do some different art for item chests that you open with one hit. So they won't look like as special as this, as these pillars do. And they'll be able to open up with one hit. They'll be smaller. Oh, why can't I get the item? That's weird. Oh, because I got full health. That's fine. So now I lost a little health. I can pick up that health. Sweet. Okay, so the actual technical implementation of it is done. Now I just got to make some better art for it. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I mean, made a lot of progress so far on this boss. He's actually really fun to fight. He's quite a challenge. And I think with these little item chests there in the corner, it's going to be more fair. Especially for newer players, people that are just getting used to this game. It's going to be a lot easier. So, yeah, so thank you all for the comments, suggestions, encouragement. Really appreciate it all. And that's it for today's video. So tomorrow, what will be tomorrow? Tonight I'll be fixing up this boss even more, you know, making this whole experience just really awesome. Tomorrow, I'm not even sure. I'm not quite sure what tomorrow will be focused on. So, I don't know. It's an adventure. We'll see. So that's it. Yeah. Thanks, guys. Yeah, like permadeath mode.